You know the cops who killed Tyre Nichols? Well, not only do they have a significant background, one woman says she directly warned Memphis PD how bad one of the cops was. All right, let's go to the video. Here it is.
We were getting a red box.
Where's your
ID? Getting a red box down.
Where's your ID?
Why you need my, what I do? What are you doing? Get this. Why I gotta step out the car? Excuse me. Why you touching her?
My hand is up, I ain't got nothing.
She's not resisting.
Where's your ID?
I'm going to explain what you just saw. Let's put up the picture of Kadejah. So Kadejah, she tried to warn the Memphis PD about an officer now charged in the death of Tyre Nichols. Kadejah said the police were at a Walgreens on February 21st, 2021. When Memphis police got a false shooting call, right? She says, and I quote, we were returning a red box and getting another red box, she said. Town said they were about to leave when a male officer approached her asking if she heard gunfire. I told him no. He told us we could go ahead and leave, she said. She put the car into reverse and when she put the car to reverse, when she said a female officer then stopped her, her unhit record on her cell phone. She wouldn't tell me what I did, Town said. She proceeded to stick her hand in my car, unlock my door, and kind of arm wrestle me. Two male officers each grabbed one of her arms and put her into handcuffs. I'm crying out, you dislocated my shoulder. He keeps saying, stop resisting, stop resisting. I'm not resisting. I'm trying to tell you, you can look at the video. My hands are behind my back, Town said. Officers then approach her aunt, and the video ends. Now remember, we've had officers tell Indisputable that they will do that in order to justify an arrest. They will start yelling, stop resisting, when they know the person is not resisting. It is a normative order for them to do. Town says officers put her into a squad car. She says she demanded they take her to the ER for her shoulder pain. Her family followed the squad car. So the officer then pulled over, got out, and drew her gun at my brother and my aunt, Town said. Town said they took her aunt into custody and her to the hospital. She then went to jail, but she said she wasn't charged with anything. She filed a complaint with the MPD's Internal Affairs Division, gave them a statement. She did not hear the results of her investigation until last month. Put up the picture. There he is. She saw the mug shots of now former officers charged, including him, right? That's Demetrius Haley. The officer who put her into handcuffs that night is that man right there. I wasn't surprised, she says, because of how they did me at Walgreens, she said. He had an official complaint. Nobody was actually prosecuted. All charges were dropped. They knew he was a problematic cop and did not care, is my point. Town's incident was in Haley's disciplinary file. WREG investigates uncovered it. He was written up in Town's case for not using force, but for filling out the proper paperwork to alert his supervisors that force was used. So he eliminated that whole notion, right? So what's happening here? Once again, culture of corruption. Culture of corruption. Haley told Internal Affairs. The cop said he did not know why they were handcuffing Towns, and the officer who helped him was not familiar with why she was pulled over in the first place. Wait a minute. Y'all don't know why y'all pulled them over, know why y'all arrested them. And this is on record. A lieutenant did say Haley routinely makes good decisions, and he was sure this was a limited event. The female officer, Alexis Brown, said while investigating the shooting call, she saw Towns laughing in her car, so she initiated the traffic stop. Laughing is against the law, obviously. She said Towns became verbally and passively resistant. What? Passively resistant? Verbally resistant? She also claimed she found marijuana in the car, but disposed of it. Yeah, and I found marijuana. So I locked them up with this petty thing, but I threw away the major one. Internal Affairs, and it's not major, it would have been major to the police. Internal Affairs said Brown violated a number of policies, including excessive force. We have requested the entire Internal Affairs case file and body-worn camera footage. Town's attorney, Carlos Moore, said he's also looking into the incident. The case was never turned over to the Shelby County DA's office for review to see if any officers did anything criminally wrong. Why was it not turned over? Culture. There's a policy to turn it over. There's a protocol to turn it over, but they chose not to. Culture, okay? That's all it comes down to, culture. Now, a man could be alive today if they simply would have practiced good protocol and common sense judgment, but they decided not to, which led to the death of Mr. Tyre Nichols. You don't have a policy issue, you have a cultural issue. Rickey, what are your thoughts here?
This is tripping me out. I think they should go back and look at every single complaint that was filed on each and every last one of those police officers. Every single complaint or whatever, I think that would help. I don't know if it would be admissible in the court with this particular case. But and then the question that I'm having, what I'm struggling with, the police chief, which I love and I support, most of our police chiefs in the country, especially like, you know, the ones that try to do the right thing. But shouldn't the police chief in Internal Affairs be investigated? Because when you reporting bad police officers and then all of a sudden they're attached to a murder or whatever and nothing was done about it because of police culture, then that's my question.
That is a hell of a question and an appropriate one.